society the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youth, the youth them of today. The future for tomorrow, they have to lead the way. Make we look into the schools, we youths not do so well. No for them I get suspended and I get expelled. When they finish primary school, they were doing very well. Them come out of the secondary, just about can spell. When it comes to sport, the youth get no support. Athletics on the football pitch and also on the court. But then you will find, when it comes to the youth, their mind. All of a sudden some teachers don't have enough time. Our youths are as intelligent as everybody else. At school they are not really taught no knowledge of themselves. They are categorized and thrown upon the shelf. They're left with only certain choices of obtaining wealth. It's all about the youths, the youth them of today. Their role in this society, the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youth them of today. The future for tomorrow, they have to lead the way. Go to get a job that is well paid. Suddenly they find out that they just don't have a grade. Lack of qualifications can bring them misery. They have to do some packing.
Yes, good day, good day, good day. This is the Stepping Razor, the Art of War. We're there with you on next Thursday. Yes, Thursday is always a good day for the Stepping Razor. We hope you are here with us, because we will be here with you. So, we have so much things upon the board here for work with. I don't know which one to start with, but I don't know if the people ever hear the term paranormal activity. That is, I don't know if it's a big word, or if I just try, you know, demean the intellect of our listeners, but there is two words named paranormal activity. We would say things not normal, it abnormal, supernatural. Well, apparently, and we don't want the whole of St. Thomas Run go down the right now. You know? We don't want the whole of St. Thomas Run go down St. Thomas Technical School at all, but apparently, Dopey take over the school. You think a joke may I make? Dopey has taken over the St. Thomas Technical School. The Dopey them, well, it's one picnic. The Dopey, apparently this spirit going on one picnic and it continue with other children to the point where the teacher them get so afraid that they run left the picnic them. When them see we are going with the picnic them, them take for the staff room and run gone, left the children them. The police them come, them afraid, them no want to do nothing, so then just stand up and look upon this thing that happen. So the church gone down there now. We hear so the church people them gone down there. If you see, me don't know if it only better carry enough olive oil, you know. It need olive oil. Remember that. Olive oil run dopey. And then them start to know. In the school, this is a school we are talking about in the bright sun at here right now. As I speak, this thing is happening. As I speak, this is happening right now. St. Thomas Technical High School. Most of the people them gone home. We are told that most of the children them gone home. Nobody no want to talk to it. No, that the teacher them no want to talk to it. The little you two, the first dopey going there. Our teacher them and our parents said them no want to say it. They call them no want nobody knows who. But really and truly now, I want to make these people know, you know, say there's two possible reasons why dopey might have taken over the school. One is that maybe we must make sure so don't lock out the children them out of the school, because there are a lot of schools now that is locking out children because them do have on the right shoes, or because them do have on a long dress, or maybe the right color underwear. But we are saying to you that differently now, maybe the school fee don't pay. The long time dopey them must say, oh, them picnic come to school and not pay the school fee. We can't catch Kwaku, which is the minister of education, so we'll catch him short. So I don't know is what happened down there. obviously something is happening, or else the people them won't be so frantic and scared that all the teachers them are run. So there's something that is happening on there, and given that, I am always figuring that St. Thomas have the most people who can exorcise ghosts. We need some of the more what we call experienced Obia man to go down there, and Obia woman, mama, papa. We need some of the more experienced people to go down to that school and see what they can do. The church people them, well, you see, the church people them now is usually the Obia people them, you know, believe you me, even though them go to church regular, but them have some little Obia thing in them. So we need some people, because apparently look like the double them left St. Elizabeth and gone to St. Thomas. I don't know why them should do that. Maybe them should have gone down at Duke Street. We need some dopey, well, maybe dopey down there already still, because the thing I get away, you know, in Jamaica. But, yeah, this is really a serious thing. Even though we attack it away, they're a serious thing. There is paranormal activity taking place in the St. Thomas Technical School, and this is really a very serious thing, because the teachers cannot help the students then, because the teachers them now running to the rock to find hiding place for themselves. And the students them decide, say, boy, all right, now we're not in that school right now, we are left. So I will put the pit in them run gone home. Very, very strange phenomena that is taking place in the bright daylight, yeah. You think say dopey go come in at night, no? You think them dopey are not easy, you know? And daylight dopey them, yeah. Oh, the thing will can't frighten we again. Can't frighten we again. You get the man that talk about, you think you can't come take Mama Africa from we again? Well, watch out now. We as dopey, I say, you think you can't come frighten me with night daylight business again? Daylight business no work. As a matter of fact, no, we can't see you no easier. So I don't know what's going to happen with this school. Yeah. I don't know if the people them are going to go back to school. Children, you know, make sure they pay the school fee. And make sure they have on the right color shoes, the right color underwear, and the long dress. Because maybe this dopey is going from school to school, but them start at St. Thomas. So maybe our next day we got here to them going to next school. But it's just weird that them should have started at St. Thomas, considering say St. Thomas is known for these things, even though it's St. Elizabeth, we did see it rise up from the other day. So that is really a news for watch out for, that St. Thomas Technical High School is under invasion by spirits that is taking over the children them and causing the children them to react and behave in certain ways that teachers have to be running away from them, and police come and don't want to do nothing. So now the church people have to go down and go knock drum and sing and pray. What? Why would be? No, trust me, we should have some kind of binoculars that can see right down at St. Thomas. No, this way I go on it. So them are not drumming and singing and praying down there right now. I mean, right now, as I speak, we're not talking about yesterday. Because right now, we hear all say staff are getting a spirit down there too. So the children, them, it attacked the children, them first, and then it move over now to the staff. So you have staffs now, teachers, who is also having this attack, the spirit attack. As I speak here, this is happening. As I speak at this moment, this thing is happening. People of Jamaica, when you see dopey start to take over school, you know that Jamaica gone away. Yes, when you see dopey start show up themselves, so all in a bright daylight, things get away. Look at St. Elizabeth the other day. For about 3 weeks straight, we are here about this dopey at turn over pattern and fire burning a house and all them things. Till eventually, the dopey just said, "Child, can't bother seeing no more now." And the dopey just burn down the house. Woman have heart attack and dead in the house. So, Jamaica, it kind of get away. It get away, believe you me. When you realize all the thing are gone now, the dopey them no afraid again. It's only gunman no afraid. Gunman are moving at night. Dopey start, first time dopey used to move in at night. and gunman a hide. But now dope them a move in a day, bright day. It's a serious thing. So I am really trying to, I'm going to invoke my spiritual powers, my spiritual powers, and see if I can direct these dopies to Garden House. We need an exorcist in Garden House for what is taking place in Jamaica, based upon of these political intrigue that is taking place in Jamaica at this moment. The latest one is the Azan affair and the Minister Palwell affair. And we see that the opposition is going to have an election, and the two of them are fighting against one another. Go like see them now no fight. A fight them a fight against one another. Because every time you hear that one and say something, the other one I say, well, look here now, we don't want it to look like we are fighting, and then the other one just say something against the other one. I don't understand these people. But them coming with a next election, and it's an internal election. I don't know why it have to be so out there. If them are going to have an election with themselves, let them have an election with themselves, Rasta. I don't care, I have no business with them. But apparently, them want the old people business with them. So, true that now we're going to play this song here. Pardon me if I play this song here, even though it's me, I do it. We have to play this song.
Well, I'm not telling you, man, so many things are going on in the country, right? You have to follow them politicians, right? You know? Tell you, man, the whole heap of people. Look how much people did last year. I used to say things don't get better. It's education. Like them out of the election right here.
Get some more education.
Jamaica.
Because of the lack of education.
Chicken bar, chicken bar, chicken
bar. The whole country mess up. You do have no eye. You're telling pure lie. You're telling pure lie. You're telling pure lie. Children gone to school. Them really are trying. The books and uniform price them so high. Now them deep on street are wet and a dry. Them really a try, them really a try, them really a try. Too much are we you them just a die. Parents can't feed them, the pygmy a cry. Now them a swallow drugs and a fly. And you know why, you know why, you know why. Everybody afraid of police, that no lie. People not trust the police, them know why. Cause every time are you dead, you hear pure lie. And you know why, you know why, you know why. The people need opportunity, that no lie. Too much corruption, I run with dry. And if them come with promise, tell them bye bye. Cause mothers are cry, children are die. I want to know why. Everyone life affected, that no lie. Want things done, you have to get a blind. Now the suicide rate can't sky high. I want to know why, I want to know why, I want to know why. I know them will use this to tell you lie. Cause them love mix up artists, but tell them not try. And if them use this song, you will know why. Cause the whole of them lie. The whole of them lie. The whole of them lie. No copy of this, no sell. I will know why. Cause when you talk them weird, yeah, them think you're high. But I don't care a damn. Me not look no blind. Cause me still say them lie. Me still say them lie. Me still say them lie. Well, Lord, my Miss Mills said them
Take note of the mayor of Savannah, Lamar, who made a statement that his predecessors already made in history. Now, we know we are going in a Jamaica, and we know, say, the things get away, but here we know. You see them state, well, we never go say that, because history proves where say history proves say certain things. When you say certain things, you get bigger. Because we remember Bustamante made the same statement again to Rasta, shoot for some ask question later, and him become a national hero. We remember the Right Honorable Hugh Larson Shearer, Prime Minister of Jamaica, made a statement that the police would shoot first and ask questions later. And he eventually was placed on the highest money in Jamaica, the $5,000 bill. So, Mr. Mayor, you saying this, you might eventually end up on a $10,000 bill when it comes. But at this moment in time, I don't know where your headspace is, the brethren, but trust me, you need to see a psychiatrist. Yeah, me, I say that. The mayor of Westmoreland, or the mayor of Savannah Lamar, mayor Bertel Moore, you need to see a psychiatrist. If in this modern time, because of your frustration with what we are going in your area, you are going to tell police, say, they must shoot young people and ask questions later. I don't know if you have a son, brethren. I don't know if you have a son, but he's a big man. And I don't know if you have a son, or your son go a party, or your son drive, or your son have other friends where them travel with. But can you imagine if after you go say that, you say police shoot your picnic, our police shoot your relative, and when you go to the policeman, them say, boy, me, I tell you the truth, me, we did have to shot him first, you know, and then figure out if him guilty or not. Can you imagine if a friend of yours pick me, I go down the road, come and know you must have a friend who have youth as son, and the youth are driving a car, and police shut up the car and kill the youth. And when the police is asked, what kind of thing that the police look at you as the mayor and say, we did have to shoot him first and then figure out if he's guilty or not, you know. Why you think about your statement, brethren? Think about it. Because in this modern time, civilized time, it's not a statement where a civilized representative of the people should say, even though we know of other people who said in this Jamaica, yeah, like a Prime Minister of Jamaica, Hugh Larson Shearer, said that already, and depend on the $5,000 bill. Others said and turn national heroes. So when you are say, it's not something new, but we don't want you to perpetuate the ignorance and the stupidity of your predecessors, which you have done. We just say, it's a terrible statement to make, considering what is going on in Jamaica now. I wouldn't say police will shoot picnic, shoot you to ask them question later, ask somebody question later. That is madness. Where you try though, brethren? Where you try though? I mean, you think that I got solve the problem of crime? You know, you would call me last night And as you hear the youth call me, you know, say, yeah, that youth will do things. And the youth tell me, say, boy, I'm out of me, I tell you the truth, you know. You think I don't know what I do, what you think I fool with fool. You think I educated, you know, educated. And a fool with fool, you know, when you see the policeman, them are going in the community, that police now say all communities stay away. I'm just restore up things. Policeman fire bullet up the other side of the road for make people up the other road piece of the man them down the other road and fire the bullet and then start grieving and that them can't come in and come shoot. It's like them are prey upon the vengeful nature of these youth. Them are prey upon the vengeful nature. So when them go so bam and fire shot, man feels that the man them down the road and fire the shot and then now them go for feed them one. And then now the police just come in and just kill everybody, kill who them for kill, and say criminal activities. And the youth them are say, but no, no, so it going on. Muta, if you understand, you know, say, you think of violence you want to defend, and of violence you want to defend, you know, but when we say, the system stay a certain way in a certain garrison area, where they mark and brand everybody. We now can just make them just kill we have, so. And that the youth has said on the radio. You just say, we're not going to make them just kill we have, so you know. And now we hear a big man who gets elected as mayor in a Jamaica. I come tell police about shoot and ask question later. That will show sick we get. Tell me if him not 6 years like the gunman them. Yeah, man, him 6 years like the policeman them. Him 6 years like the gunman them. Him need to see a psychiatrist rather for analyze him anger. Because of certain things that take place in Jamaica. Then maybe we should just go out and just go shoot everybody. Just go shoot any youth where he look certain way. Any youth where he say bleach, just shot him. Any youth where he say have on him tight pants, just shot him. Any youth where he just say a walk with him pants down, just shot him. And then you figure it out later. Or you're going to know a man, a criminal, by just looking upon him. Because sometimes you see all a man and you hold him and you carry him go to jail and you feel him guilty or something. And then you go do an investigation and realize you have to go let him go. He is only a person of interest. But guess what? It no means him guilty. And according to phone law, a man is proven innocent. He is innocent until proven guilty. Me no see that in Jamaica. Me see a man guilty and you have to go prove say you're innocent. And that means you go on in Jamaica. Me not see nobody talk about say man innocent until proven guilty. No, a policeman catch up on the road, him just lock you up. That means say him assume say you're innocent, you're guilty. And now you have to go get lie, you have to prove say you're innocent. Because right away when him lock you up, you know it means say you're guilty. If a policeman arrest you, it means say you're guilty, and you have to go prove say you're innocent. So this foolishness about proving innocent. Until innocent till proven guilty, it no work. Most youth will go to jail them like them same guilty, and him have to go prove him innocence. So this mayor said, shoot them, and then you come figure it out later. May I tell you, it's a sick statement, man, disgusting statement. Considering so we as Rasta go through that already with the society. Rasta go through that already. If Bogil can't hold them, then the prison don't Barnet Street will hold them. Prime Minister come out when him sister turn thing go on with them create. Because in them time, it was the political of evil go on in Jamaica. And at them same politician they create, the two party them in Jamaica, start the gun thing in Jamaica. Issue gun to the youth them. And the gun them start to fire left and right. Every one of the party them have a man where them where defend for them turf for them that them can win back election. Now the politician them can't control the youth them again because the youth them are get them own gun now from foreign. The youth them are get them own things now come from foreign. And the youth them, some of the youth them are turn police and can't get the things them from police too. Because you have certain youth where, yes, them police there, and my boy, them that, you know. That's why certain people don't want to say certain things in a certain area. Because from a man go talk, go tell a police, say, you want to see that brother there, rape my daughter, I rape my sister, you know. The same police go tell all the man, say, you want to say, John Tom, come down and see each other and complain, say, you rape him daughter, and you know, I rape him woman, and you know. I'm saying, yeah, that the boy do. Little more you hear, say, the boy finding some barrel or some gully bank or something dead. You wonder how that possible. So we find, say, the thing stay away. So when a man talk about shoot first, I ask question. I want to know which part him live. Where him live. Because you see, as him says, so now, something not going happening in him life, you know. As so the karma going, you know, something not going happening in him life. We prove, say, it's not a right statement that. Something not going happening in him life. When we go see, say, that statement they shouldn't make as a mayor. A mayor, which is, you're different from just an ordinary citizen. You know, see, you run a certain era in a Jamaica. You're responsible for a certain amount of people in a Jamaica. And not because your parish, you claim now, according to the guys them around the thing, say, your parish have a serious problem. It's like a fourth murder town, murder city in a Jamaica. Or where you want to say town or city. The fourth more murders are going in your town, and you know, come and say that, Bridget. No sir, me no know. You don't have to apologize to you because you don't go to your bed yet, and it bother you in your heart, or something do happen to somebody who you know, but close to you. For sure, you say them statement they can't make it at them time, yeah. Them statement they can't make them time there, because watch now. And we are linking to the alligator thing too, because watch out. You know, so the gear guys them just, you know, have a fight against gear and they say enough, they say nothing. So how come all a man can stand up in a Jamaica and say police must shoot people first and ask question later? And he mean authority. He mean authority, you know. Little Queen Africa and no authority. She does a certain thing based up off a fair little lifestyle and fair little artistic expression. And you hear them stop her from the show and all them something there. Stop her from the this and stop her from the that. No man tell Jamaican police to kill people without any investigation. So how do you see that? How do you see that? Jamaican people who are listening to me right now. How do you see that somebody stand up and I declare, say, this is how me stay. This is where me I defend. Me not tell nobody to kill nobody. Me not tell nobody to harm nobody, but this is how me stay. And a group of people don't say, watch out, you're not supposed to say that. Not in front of thousands of people. And you know what me gonna do? Me gonna make sure, say, when you go far and go to show, we're going to just make the people them boycott your show. Yet still, a man who is in authority can get up in front of people and declare, say, police, you see the way the crime are going on in Westmoreland, yeah? You know, if you shot the boy them before, you know, ask them nothing. And all them can't get this some little write up in a paper. That's all. You don't see that as funny. You don't see that as weird and strange. That man in an authority can get up and say them thing there. And no consequence. There's nothing happening towards him authority and towards how people view imposition in Jamaica. Yes, still man ostracize a little sister because she defend her way of life. And I say something where it don't talk about no killing. Him a talk about killing. This guy a talk about kill people. Him say shoot them. Him can't afford the call of them killing their guan in a Jamaica, especially in a fin town. Shoot them and then ask question later. You can just imagine if we get up on stage and use the same language against a group of people in a Jamaica. Where that year? Or oh, them would have taken you off a radio. Them would have, the whole newspaper would have full up of it. foreign press that come down here and said this and said that and them thing. I said, no, we can't have them thing there. Modern society. Jamaica is a modern society and we can't have this democratic country and this and that. And we know what the crime violent. But it's like, yeah, the mayor is still the mayor tomorrow. This brethren is still the mayor tomorrow. And I'm going to continue as being mayor. Because nothing now will come out of that. But me, I have to say something about it because I feel it is despicable. That in this modern time, guy should have said that. Because we never did like when Shira did say it. Much less we come like it right as or now. And we see Shira gone on $5,000 bill. You understand? So, maybe down the line, you see the mayor there on a $10,000 bill. If you do it good enough value, nothing like the $5,000 bill. Stepping razor. We depend the art of war. Brand new. The art of war. You know, I listened to the news a while ago and we hear them talk about the eating. You mustn't eat the alligator them. Because people seem to be, well, I mean, I tell you, Jamaica get away. Jamaica get a rare rasta, trust me. Anyway, them are saying, the crocodile must not be eaten. You know what them say is an endangered species. And it is illegal to interfere with or be in possession of any part of the animal. You hear them say? It is illegal to be in possession of any part of the animal. It is an endangered species. Now, the problem with me have with these things, you know, is that these people at pick and choose which animal they must have compassion for and which animal they mustn't have compassion for. When them see him, when I tell you, say, God make all of the living things them. But you know what I say now? Because them said this a bird season time, you know. You remember mentioned that a couple weeks ago, say a bird season time where this is the time when uptown people who have gone get a chance to indiscriminately kill bird. And them have certain bird with them and say you mustn't shot. It's a bird season in the Rasta. The bird them in a traumatic experience, you know. So may I ask, where the Jamaica Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals there? Because if you can indiscriminately kill bird as a sport, you know them say, when the hunter kill the lion, him call it a game. And when the lion kill the hunter, them say the lion is a savage beast. Then suppose all the dog them in Jamaica decides they're going to organize themselves and say, on February, we're going to just bite up school picnic. Really. Them just organize up themselves. All dogs in Jamaica on February, we are going to bite up school children. You know how much dog would have dead? And you know, the dog them get vicious. You know, why the dog them get vicious? You them bite up our school picnic. I suppose the birds them, you have a movie named The Bird, you know, Alfred Hitchcock movie named The Bird. The birds, where the birds them just organize themselves and just start kill people. We're calling upon the society, just the Jamaica Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, to not only concern themselves with them beloved poodle and them Rottweiler and them dear the beloved fluffy cat, but recognize the sanctity of all living creatures on earth. You know, business where nobody wants to say. And so we see it. Because you have man now who, he must say, him love animal, but him name them every day. What kind of love that? Or you love animal and I eat them? Well, I mean, love animal, but you, him love the goat because the goat tastes nice. And him love the cow because, yeah, you know, cow tripe. Him can't eat the cow tripe. And him eat the liver. It's a terrible thing, you know, when a man decides he's going to go inside of the guts and the belly of an animal, you know, and take out the parts of the animal, them and start to make food out of it, you know, Rasta. Yes, it's weird. Because me see animal, me see dead animal upon the road already, you know. Me see a cow dead all upon the Maypen road and a certain road. And when me look, me see all of the inside of the goat, the cow, just gush out upon the road. And I mean, I say, but wait there. And that people put you on the dining table, you know, that's that. The same tripe and the same kidney and all the things them were in the cow where you don't ever want to walk past it, you know. Can you imagine you see a dead cow on the road and you don't ever want to walk, you walk over the other side because the dead cow now go get up on the nothing, you know. It's like how people afraid all a dead rat. It's like the dead rat. They run down the rat, you know, when they are rat live, you know, but it's when the rat dead, them no one go near the dead rat. Well, I see when people stay with cow, you know. Like you see a dead cow or a dead goat upon the road. Or a dead dog upon the road. It's like they want to go upon the other side of the road. But guess what? Upon Sunday, they see a dead cow where they're upon the roadside, you know. A guy just come there, so take the inside of the goat, the cow, chop out the foot, chop out the tail, and just go carry that, go somewhere and just skin that. And just sell it back. The same person who afraid of it, just sell it back. And Sunday dinner you have. Tripe and bean. Human being with a sad state of affair, Rasta. With a sad state of affair. But one day, these animals will rebel against human beings. Planet of the animals, they will rebel. And I am calling upon all the animals in Jamaica to rebel against these wicked people who feel to them should have eaten every day and don't feel no way. But when somebody kill one of them start to make out a big thing out of it. Animal killed human being, yes, them shot the animal. Human being kill animal, you say, yes, the animal for dead, it's just an animal. It don't have nothing to do with nothing. Eh? Watch and see what I got, man. You remember that movie, The Planet of the Apes? Yes. Serious thing, Planet of the Apes. The apes then become human beings and them thinking and decide say human beings is disgusting. And we are, because no animal is destroying the planet. It's human beings that destroy the planet. Make it miserable for all living creatures and things to live on. Yet still man claims that them is the highest form of being on earth. What is the highest form of being? Professing and projecting wars against each other, killing of the animals, destroying the atmosphere with them all sort of this and that, and then them say them love animals. It's a strange love affair. That brand new music by the man called Busy Signal. Me talk about now my age group and beyond, you know. No say. Only if you listen to the lyrics there, you know, because I know say the language barrier there. Because the street slang and we don't know about, we don't know use street, but the youth them say some things in them lyrics, in them music. And last night the music I make, because it mentioned a youth just dead name Roach. Producer, dancehall music producer. Where did I produce enough music and them shot him up a Mary Brown's car and so. And it weird because them shot the bridge in there and then the next day we hear to the police them going a Vibes Cartel cell and find 2 cell phone and then them going a Zebra. You remember Zebra? We get charged for rape most about umpteen times and they are prison for rape. Them going to go find him with a SIM card and also a piece of paper that have on a very popular artist name on it. So apparently they are making a connection between what took place, the killing of Roach. Because just as it happened, them run gone in a Vice Cartel and them find him with 2 phone in there. I don't know if him lie, them I gonna say them never find a phone in there now, but obviously them find some phone in there now, and him not supposed to have phone in there, but obviously like them I use make the music them and whatsoever them I use, but it's a serious thing. So he was busy seeing all the comments and I said, well, everything I go on the same way, not change. Everything I just go on the same way. Yes, my fear sing the same tune, them same way. And not no guy, because them kill Bogle and now them come kill Roach. I just the same thing, same way. Same way, get the money, same way, yeah. Okay, not much change, same way. Me in a good place, I buy some, same way, yeah. We are not sitting all over,
same way, miss, same way. I watch out for this, the whole world, I play number one, but they miss now, miss, same way. Things ain't about people, I stay away. The problems we have, chant a prayer day. The same way, them kill brother, them kill road, same way. Can't know what the things set away, them loot and now pray. Same way,
dear father,
to you, me a pray. When time rough and we in this, me turn the dark sky to blue sky. Same way, and the piece of food, so me also same way. You say them a wire down a town, same way. Shut a fire, same way. West Kingston, same way. From my day, same way. Same way, same way. Some police a gunman, same way. Anyway, them one control where them and but me sang them a fi play, same way. Tour book, same way. We fly, same way. Book out, same way. Black show, same way. Face is same way. That is same way. That love me, same way. Like the turf, same way. Attack, same way. Me, same way. A killer, me general.
Cross.
Same way. We whack them, whack them, whack.
A terrible thing I go on because the thing I get worse. You know that? You know the thing I get worse. Then if the thing never get worse, oh, me, I cannot come out and I say shoot a question later because the thing I get worse. You know, say, so I go on yesterday. Hey, I want no know where I go on. The thing I just see him way. Everything just go on, see him way. You know, so the corruption still I continue. You know, see, so them come with the next election and if you tell the people them more lie again. You know, so they must celebrate 70 years of People's National Party, and they really been to them and do something good. Where you go around, I don't know which part them are listen to, who them are listen to, but the people them feel aware. Them not feel good. Look how the road them steer. Me don't know if them people are driving on a different road, or is a overcraft politician use when them are drive. I wonder if them pioneer and all them thing there, anytime them left Parliament or them office, them just have a overcraft. We just take them over the road them and all over the pothole them and nothing happen to feed them care. Because right now all people are foreign. I call me and I say, why Muta, you ask me down to Jamaica the other day now? Or the road them stay so rasta. You know what I'm a bridging them from England, I call me and I tell me say, it's where I go and down to Jamaica rasta. Me just come down the other day for a couple of days and me I tell you the road them stay away. Then the people them not see that. Not the people them, but the government. Because every day man a black road and I show you how the patrol them say. The other day, big accident happened because a guy tried to serve out a patrol and go over the other side of the road and look how people kill people and all them here. They look how woman off a bicycle and them thing. Oh, it gets so. Because now the crime a problem. Patrol a problem. Everything stays the same way. And just so. It just a go on and a go on and a go on and. Sometimes it doesn't stay the same way. Sometimes a whole heap it get worse. There's a report coming out of Sri Lanka. This man is claiming that the Chinese is exporting prisoners. According to this man, a lot of the Chinese workers, especially in film country, because there's a piece of island, and it's weird because there's a little island off the coast of Sri Lanka where the Chinese are trying to buy for some development, or try lease for the development. And the government claim say, no, it's going to destroy the environment. And this is way over the other side of the world we are talking about. Anyway, this professor is saying that the Chinese is using prisoners outside of China as workers in places like Angola and Zambia, Ghana, and all these places. And ironically, the people, I mean, we know about how propaganda machine work. We know that there's a economical war that is taking place between America and China. There's a big economical war where right now America owe China about $1 trillion. But I will know when you America, when you America, you know, and when them say them economical foundation a collapse. Cause right now them a plan for lockdown the government. Again, them a plan for do it. But what about in America? But America have a way for use propaganda for demonize other countries. Like when them tell you about Iraq and the weapons of mass destruction and there was none. You know, and there's so many other examples of the demonizing of leaders of countries that America seem to be saying that it's threatening their way of life. So we don't hold it past them if you say them not spread propaganda about China. But the problem with it is that this story that is circulating all over the world, people in Zambia and Ghana and Angola is actually saying that it's true. That there's a lot of workers that the Chinese bring from China. And when I talk about technical workers, no, we are talking about mixed cement kind of worker where you can't get in any country. But you know, say the Chinese them are bring them own workers them, even for mixed cement and nail up board. That is why a whole heap of these countries now is not truly getting the serious benefit, economical benefit that them supposed to get. Because the leaders them is not signing any paper for say there must be a certain percentage of workers from the country that the development is taking place in. So as to provide jobs for the people who do have no jobs, especially all in Jamaica now. The problem is not that the Chinese is coming to Jamaica. The problem is, will it benefit Jamaica when the Chinese come? I will not say a man must make money, because if him have something in mind and him invest in it, him supposed to make billions of dollars. But it must mean, say, because I make billions of dollars, me must still live behind zinc fence when me I work for him. No, me supposed to can build up good fence. You know, see, if it's even paint the zinc fence, them and do graffiti upon the zinc fence, them that zinc fence, them can look proper. So, me not have no problem with the Chinese, them I come to Jamaica. You know, me not have no problem with it. The problem is that, what are Jamaican people going to benefit from these so-called economical intervention? And who are these workers that the Chinese is bringing? Because now we hear other countries is saying that, you know, out of the prison they might take them. Remember Christopher Columbus? Christopher Columbus couldn't get nobody to come and so with him, you know, because they said, I'm going to drop off of the world because the world is flat, according to them. So they have to go into the prison them in Spain and take out all the prisoner them and promise them gold and land. That is why I'm getting them three ship them to get full up a sea line, you know. It's land and gold him offer them because no sensible man in Spain or educated man in Spain wanted to leave Spain to come prove if the world did flat or if it did round. And we say Britain did do that too in history. Cause a lot of what did full of Port Royal. I mean, our people don't know that history there, you know. A lot of what did full of Port. A whole heap of criminal did end up in a Port Royal, you know. That when the man them rob the other ship them, all the Spanish ship them and the French ship them, you know, them bring all of them things come dash down a Port Royal and they make Port Royal become an evil place, dangerous place. Man used to just get drunk and just cut out man heart, you know, and walk up and down in a Port Royal. Hey, you think a joke me I make a history that and a black history me I tell you about, you know, where people write from that side there. We tell you how wicked Port Royal become. That when we go to school, when we had studied about Jamaican history at school, you know, me used to Port Royal was the wickedest place on earth. Can you imagine that it's still a fella with shoes like the dopey from them time there? Compound at them time, yeah. That Jamaica, Port Royal, was seen as the wickedest place on earth. That is why people say, that's why an earthquake did have to shake it. Because earthquake shake Port Royal, almost sink it underneath the water. That is how Port Royal become famous. Two, one, it was the wickedest place on earth. And two, a big earthquake come shake it. And people say, yeah, it must get shaped because it is so wicked. And we say that same wickedness there transplant itself and transcend into time and space and reach us when we know. So it is not an impossible suggestion or thinking that these people in these African countries have when this man make this statement that the Chinese is exporting prisoners to do jobs in different countries. The probability, at least it is possible. It is possible. But as we say, the Chinese is in Jamaica a long time, years them there. And we did a live with them side by side all the while. It's just that there is a phobia that is taking place because of this government. All we are going, you know, are the government cause the people them be so China-phobic about this thing, you know. Call them, I call them dress-up slave. Well-dressed slave in some Italian suit, jacket and tie. Slave masters, overseers. You see, through them a bob and weave and a scheme with the people them start to feel animosity against the people them. So we are say, really and truly, we don't know where we are going in our China because we will never know when these guys sit down. We don't know if they really did done sell goat island already and just a go on light. We don't know if them did done make arrangements, sign paper and everything. Because these people have a way to do things round the corner and then up front come tell you this and tell you that. And then them go on. Like how the brother on the TV talk about me, Azan. And I say, Azan, no worry yourself, man. You'll get through this, you know. It's a Jamaican people and 9 days one of them work with, you know. So it's after 9 days, everything I got us done. I saw the man they know. So you know, see the man they don't care about how Jamaican people think, you know. Because them know, say, there's a culture of we go on away and make noise. And for the 9 day, the 9 night, it just dead and done. Because a 9 day thing, it come out for the 9 night, where we usually have the 9 night. We have a 9 night celebration, and that is it. You understand? And we are say, the man I say, yeah, Mr. Hassan, don't worry yourself, man. We are comrade for life. And I can't get you out. I'm in a business with them. Hey, you are, you're the brother for the TV, you understand? I say, yes. Yes, brethren, go ahead, do ya do. If so, them can't get you out. I just wait, man. I just 9 days. A 9 day wonder this, you know, Mr. Hassan. A 9 day wonder this. After 9 days, them nobody remember nothing about nothing. So, me no know. Me no know because Hassan, them come out, come find, say, why some little discrepancies go on in this thing, yeah? Well, if a discrepancies too. We don't know how that going to work out here now. But the man says a 9 day wonder, and the Prime Minister now say nothing. Them still the pan TV at behave arrogant. So the lady pan TV at say, look here, we don't answer no question, you know. We have to wait till we see certain papers. That the papers done, so the Prime Minister they done say after the man them do them the contractor people them do them thing, them are gonna come back and tell you, say, well, this is that and this is that, and then they will figure out the next step. But apparently there's a scare for really come to grips with where the man come find out. And the contractor general I said, well, them must have some disciplinary action against Richard Hassan. And them afraid for go have that disciplinary action now because they have to go examine the 100 odd people. Well, I tell you, the politician, you know, easy, the rasta. We are telling you, say, them come like fern gully, you know, twist and turn. Hey, believe you me, man. them people, you know, hey, you see, if them just have a highway if you drive on, the whole of them crash, you know. But you see, them know if you twist and turn, and just put you up the thing, you know. Come here, Mr. Charles, I talk on the TV, you know, me, I say, Mr. Charles, believe you me now. What you say, that's why you say about every election where you run. So you don't have to do nothing new. And when you're in a power, you don't say nothing change, nothing different. And you come now and run against your own man now, and you go and like say you're going to do something different. And it's the same thing. You're dangerous, you know? Politician. You have some good people, when you're not politician, you know? You have some nice people, you know? Believe in me. But it's almost like there's a spirit, a political spirit, that when a man win election, the spirit just jump in him and him just become a different person. He or she, no care how she pretty, no care how she nice, no care how you can get on with her or him. When they become politically powerful, it's like there's a spirit there where make your norm, the normal, and that them no feel them can do something good, you know. Because them really believe that they can make a difference in the landscape. You know, them really believe that, you know. But guess what? The power, man. The power. It's the power thing. I know the system set up. The system. Nobody wants to rock the boat. So all you hear are some little university youth now talk about this and this and this and that. And the same education them come get. That means if them have the opportunity and go in there, the same way they're going to react to situations. What a serious quagmire we now. Terrible thing.
When you think loans, think Chris and Charles Investments. Call
97745078. Stepping razor.
You better try if you help yourself. To provide me all the way. Feel good for your bread that you him have a care of fear. No need.
Yeah, man. Been listening to your commentary, you know. Mm-hmm. Really riveting.
Yeah.
Well.
Which one of them? Which one of the commentary them? Because enough things we are talking about, you know.
Yes, well, the that, shoot first and ask.
Oh, the mea, the one that's happening.
Yes.
Yes.
Which, you know, the highlight that you put on it.
You don't see some action should be taken against that mea Rasta.
But he should be sent away from the post immediately.
Yes. Yes.
Immediately.
Yes.
Because what you're inciting is the killing of innocent
Jamaican
people.
Citizens.
Yes, who innocent you don't people.
Who you don't know if them guilty or not.
Well, this is it.
Yes.
This is it. But, you know, the wider picture, you know, we have to look on is that how the guns get here in the first place.
Well, the politician that originally started.
The same politicians. And who have been supporting it is America. I remember, yeah. America is a gun culture.
All right, hold on the bridging. Hold on there.
Upgrade your landline and internet experience with DigiHome.
The station, I forget it. Look at you.
Yeah.
No, we have to look at the whole problem, you know, that America is a gun culture.
Yeah.
And America make most of their money by the sale of weapons.
Yeah.
All of these $1 million and $2 million smart bomb. Remember in the early 90s when America was in one of the worst recession, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Them start the invasion of Iraq and bomb all places when a war never go on. Them bomb it.
Yeah.
No, I go at the U.S. library, you know. Go inside, they go read that America got 90% of the contract to rebuild Iraq and Kuwait, you know.
Halliburton.
Aye.
Yeah, man.
So when you realize
Cheney was part of Halliburton with the executive.
Cheney, of course. The U.S. Secretary
Vice
of Defense.
President. He was the Vice President at the time.
At the time.
Yeah.
So you have to understand the mindset of these people going around the world, creating all these wars and strife because them have to sell them gun and boom and weapons.
Yeah.
So anywhere there is civil unrest and war, gun go and sell.
Them strive for it.
And when you look at what is happening to Jamaica now, when Michael Manley in the 70s, you know, started his democratic socialism experiment, them say it's communism ago, and them going to stop it. And the CIA sent in guns, you know, we have the tape where the German them do, you know, the Germans did a documentary named Life and Death.
Mm.
And in it, them show you the picture of the thing from Washington, you know. I tell you, say, America had to destabilize the government of Manley. Mm. And they sent 10 guns it there.
No, but we have, remember, a couple months ago, we play a document by a CIA brethren who did there, so, who investigate how America tried to destabilize Jamaica in the 70s.
Yes, him write a book to you, know. Him write.
No, it's more than one of them, you know. It's not even one, you know. Can I remember Agri, one man, the name Agri.
Philip Agri, right. Yeah, he did one, yes.
Yeah, him was one, but that different one with that talk about, you know, but. Yeah, there's a documentation for sure, so them do that. Definitely.
Yeah, man. So you see, it's not like, say, them a hide and do it. Them a show you, say, them a do it. Because them is a superpower and nobody can test them. The whole thing with America, you know, them is the watchdog for the world and nobody can come to them. Because it's them emasculate Russia and all of the other superpowers where could are equal to them.
Yeah.
So right now, anything America want, America get, because of that stance that they have taken now as the ruler of the world.
Yeah.
Now, when we look on it now and we are say, boy, oh, we can't control the gun and the ammunition them coming into the island. Is them same one, because remember the diplomatic flight them, you know, nobody search them, you know. All of these diplomatic flight, when them come in, customs can't go there and search nothing. So you don't know what them bringing in.
Yeah, but we do another two certain things still, you know. You have Jamaican people who bring in gun to the country. In a video machine, in a television.
You have the corrupt one, them that support that.
No,
that
it's wally pa, it's wally pa them that like little bit, you know, like in a television set, in a video set, all sorts of way. Them have a way for bringing tea. Bring it in with rice, bring it in with flour. Bring all sorts of way them bring it
yes,
to China.
Yes, so, them smuggle it in. But as I say, you know, they have so much unprotected airstrip in the island now that a man can just fly in. Remember in the old days with the ganja man, build him little airstrip and him bring in him plane, pick up him ganja and him gone.
Mm.
So these things is taking place still.
Mm.
Ships will come in and dock out in the harbor there and a man run in with some things. You don't know what it is.
Yeah, gun.
Gun and ammunition.
And run out with some drugs.
That is part of the exchange thing.
Yeah, transshipment port. Yeah.
So we have to now look at, say, the policy makers then, our politicians who we have, they are not doing enough to maintain the sovereignty of our island.
I don't think them know what to do.
Well, I don't think they know what to do, but they don't have the will to do it.
Mm.
You know, all right, I'm going to tell you something. At the other day, my research, did you know that, all right, we know say Jamaica is not an independent state because the Queen is the head of the country, so you can't independent.
Mm.
But even within that day when them assigned the proclamation to say them get this independence, there were certain conditionalities that were put to it. You have a treaty named the system named the Bretton Woods system, which was the economic system, the monetary system where you lock yourself into. Now, within that system, you know, you can't get independence if no nation went under colonial rule could have gotten independence if they never signed on to that Bretton Woods system. That was the first condition. And then the other conditions in the Bretton Woods system say, whenever you have a balance of payment deficit, you must go to the IMF. So this is how them lock you straight into the system. That means you can't come out of it.
And then the thing get worse.
It must get worse because the IMF now go and tell you the conditions where you get the money under now. Lay off certain workers. Do this, do that. And it go and create your country in a downward poverty spiral that you can't come out of. The US dollar, you know, our dollar was 77 cents to one US dollar, you know.
Yeah, man, remember.
77
man.
Cents. That means we were stronger than the US dollar.
You remember, man. In the 70s, early all 70s. Right. Yeah, man.
And today we are now $102 Jamaican to one US dollar. That is 13,000%, you know. You devalue, you know. 13,000%. 8%.
But I want to tell you something last night. I tell you, say, when I left school, I'm going to work at Jamaica telephone company. At $25 a week, me used to get.
Because 25. Of the strength of the money.
I mean, I talk about, like when we say 25 now, we mean 250 or 2,500. I mean, I talk about literally, $25
yes.
a week, yes. me used to get. I mean, I have to pay rent out of that.
Rent and eat food and have yeah. money to buy electricity.
Bus fear and all them things there.
Because the currency is strong them time there.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to tell you now, I want you remember same time in the 70s, then now some people named Rockefeller, it come from the Rockefeller Commission.
Yeah, yes.
All right. When they came to Jamaica, you know, as an investment team, David Rockefeller, when they leave Jamaica, say, well, you know, we really can't invest, you know. Because your dollar too strong. Your dollar supposed to be 100 to 1 before we can. I'll never forget that thing there. Your dollar must be 100 to 1 before we can invest in your country. So
maybe him come now. Them will come now then.
Him get him way now.
Yeah man, give thanks, brethren.
Blessing.
Give thanks. Yes, a serious thing I go on round way and in a way. It's not gonna go round way to go on, but in a way, because the people them we confuse. We don't know. We forgot either or thither. Yeah, man. And the confusion is created there to create more confusion in the minds of the people them. And you can look and see, say, we don't really know what to do. We don't know what to do. I mean, we see the something that happened in front of you. It's like a car come lick you. And you know, car, you know, a little space. And the car come lick you, and you can't go left, and you can't go right, and you can't go forward, and you can't go back. We know say it's going to happen, you know, but we don't know what to do. You understand? And the people them who were supposed to know what we're supposed to do, is them that create the problem. Yeah, them that create the problem. Some don't know. Terrible thing. Terrible thing.
Hello, Muta.
Yeah, blessed.
Blessed. Last week, me I talked about some university students where I reason with and.
Oh, yeah, about the African West Indian thing, yeah.
So, them that said them are Jamaican?
No. Them said them are trying to reiterate the West Indian argument.
Yeah.
Because me never did I tell them to them are not Jamaican, you know. Me I tell them to them are not Indian.
Right.
And it's a misdemeanor when you have African people of African descent. I refuse. Them I said them is not African.
That them say them are not African.
Yeah, them say them are not African. Yeah, some youth we are doing things up at university. Them say them are not African. Them are West Indian. And me I try to show them now. Say, but looking at the mirror and look if you look like an Indian, and them a laugh. You know, it's like.
Even the American, they don't call themselves African American, you know.
Yeah, well, so, them knowing that. Them not say them are not African to me. Them say them are not African because they never go to Africa yet. They don't know about African.
Anyway, what we really want to call it, but more reason upon something.
Mm-hmm.
Before we get independence, right?
Mm-hmm.
We are under British rules, right?
Yeah.
And we get independence in 1962.
That's what them say, yeah.
Right. And then after we get independence now. Before we get independence, we are Jamaican. We are British now.
We are Jamaican, man. British subject, but Jamaican.
British subject.
Yeah, yeah.
So
Commonwealth people. We are still Commonwealth. But yeah, we are Jamaican before. Of course, we are Jamaican before.
Yeah, but all right, you rule under British, yeah. And if you rule under, you're part of the British colony. Don't say
Empire. Yeah,
you're supposed to can traverse to
Queen Elizabeth. Yeah, we used to do that, you know. I just said they put visa there, you know.
Hold on, me said, but who born like within me 50 within my time?
Yeah,
people born with them time. What kind of passport them supposed to have?
You're supposed to have a Jamaican passport.
No, if you born in 1960. What kind of passport you have? A Jamaican or a British passport?
Jamaican passport.
And the Jamaican passport.
Hold on. Alright, tell you the honest truth now. You have me away yet or no? Because me not remember if it's a British passport or whatever, a Jamaican passport.
No, we just have reason it out there. Look for it.
Yeah.
May I say?
Yeah.
If you're under British rule.
We're
right?
supposed to have a British passport.
Right. So may I say people who born up to 1962. Before independence. Them supposed to have a British passport.
Yeah.
And them supposed to follow a British colony. So them supposed to traverse to and from. People born after 1962. Them are Jamaican now, so them no longer British rule.
Yeah, but when I say, we used to traverse to and fro up to in the 90s, yeah, you know.
Yeah, but I agree, but they have said that shouldn't stop for the people.
Well, hear why them said stop now, because Jamaica and England got colonized England in a reverse.
Yeah, but even that, you're born on a British, Cayman people, them are subjected to, and all of them have British passports, can't travel to and from.
Yeah.
So if you born before independent, by right, you're a British.
Yeah.
You don't understand what I'm saying?
No, I understand what you're saying, but it's not good away there.
No, it's not good, but I said it's true, because when the last time we have the Olympics, I mean, I said the man, I'm going to tell people, said people forget visa. Now, foolish that.
Yeah.
Half of subject to so much.
Well, you have to have visa for go to St. Martin.
Yeah, I understand that, you know. I understand where they're putting it, but I say, nobody now look in terms of when me are saying no for the Jamaican people, the people that were born before that, because they know where you should have made people like power, me and you, over tell you to forget visa for go to Britain.
Yeah, but you can't decide that. You're a little colonial country there.
I agree with you,
but you can't decide that.
No, me can't decide that, but me are saying me when me born, so me know what, is that me want to go there?
Yeah, me understand what you are saying, but it's where you are saying.
But me are saying me born after them colonial
system. Yeah, but where you are saying.
And then you change it.
Yeah, then the same way them change homosexual thing, probably after them don't put in them Bible say it wrong, and now them come to say we
accept it. Them change it for them, they can't change it for me.
No, but that me assure you, say them change with them want change.
And nobody stand up that them think the government should have fight, because there's no way. No, we me and you should have go long place and I go tell yourself we want to go to England and forget that for here.
Yeah.
We supposed to do what?
Go free.
Right.
Okay. Who are going to run the airplane? Them. I got to ask you, who are run the airplane for them to pay for the airplane
no,
seat?
No. We are going to pay for the gas. Basically, that you just get up now and you just go you book your flight and you just fly
gone, yeah.
Like what you should do, you just come tell us and you forget visa. If after 1962, one bar we come independence, a different thing.
Yeah.
And all these two, them people, that's when I think where people should have sit down and work out with them and show say, I saw it, I forgot.
Yeah.
When was British flag, you know?
I keep repeating the same thing. Me hear what you say, man. Me hear what you say.
Well, that's something you like to check out, you know.
No, but me not have to check that out. I mean, it can't change. It not going to change.
But
what you want to change, man? Why you want to have a British passport?
No, me don't want to have it, you know, but me just have
to. Yeah, but you say, me must check it out. Like, say, if me check it out now, me will come with a different argument.
No, but probably when you check it out, you can make a difference. Make a change.
By doing what? Change it for what? Where you want to change it for? If it doesn't have no visa, that you say?
What is that? No,
why you want to change?
Why
you want a British passport?
If me by chance for go to, me no have to go into the hassle for go before I get visa and get out.
Well, anyway, you're going to know you have to go into the hassle. Anyway, you're going to know Jamaican. You know, you them say Jamaican people and Asian people can't get this kind of passport.
And anyway, you go. If you come to Jamaica, you're in the hassle.
No, me talk about anywhere Jamaican can go. Me not talk about when the people are coming. So you have a free for all place.
Okay.
You know, see, a free for all place. This. Yeah, like, anyway, give talk, Bridget.
All right, cool.
Yes. Yeah. All right. Empress Sativa.
Hello.
Yes, blessed.
All right, how you doing?
All right, ma'am.
Since Martin Aplana, Rascal, Michael and the Sons of Negus, Peter Tosh, Chester from Wildman Street, we grew up with him. Bob Marley, since them Rasta man there, you think the Rasta movement has stagnated into just being a close enough politician like Mayor Bertie from Westmoreland and...
No, hold on.
Them in order to get a hype, now them of course politicians.
Yeah, but I know Rasta alone of course the politician. Then.
No, but me I say if Rasta, the edification of youngsters like myself, my brother too, still a Rasta man.
Right.
Sarge from Southside and them man there. You think from them?
Yeah, but me ask you a question.
Rasta man, you think the movement stagnate?
No, but me ask you a question. No, me talk about me personally. No, you think some me a teach you them anything?
No.
You don't think me a teach you them nothing?
No, you just cut. Oh, you don't think?
You don't think me a teach you them nothing?
Nothing at all. Because if you're the real,
the whole land, you know, at 20 years me depend on the radio, you know, between cutting it, at 1 year
me.
In a cutting edge for 20 years, you know, hear me a teach you them nothing.
Alright, you see if you're the teacher.
No, hear what me a say, no, me ask. You say no.
Yeah, no.
Alright, so the next thing now is that So how come the youth them I say that?
The youth them I say that?
Yeah. How come the youth them I say, boy, Muta, are you make me know certain things and are you make me go up on internet and are you? How the youth them I say that? How
when me,
I
say that? When me did I grow, you see?
Yeah.
When Rasta teach for things, we could have, we used to have knit.
Them me not using it. Rasta never used it on radio.
You
know, when
you know, youth are you say you're teaching. Me not see no youth are dealing in Rasta culture these days.
You not see no youth. You not see no youth are plant food. You not see no youth are plant no food.
Plant what?
You not see no youth are plant no food.
Plant what?
Which part you live? Where you live?
Me?
Yeah, where you live?
Me live in the Mullines Garden area.
Yeah, where you never see nobody a plant nothing. You never see nobody now. Anyway, about the cousin, about the cousin of the me, I know. You ever know? You know why we say nothing about what the mayor say?
All right, what the mayor say? The mayor say shoot.
Shoot right? Ask question later.
I never hear the ask question, I just shoot.
No, but that him said quote, it quote in the newspaper, it quote everywhere, shoot.
I'm going to hear a story.
No, not give me no story, man. Not give me no story.
No, man, I'll tell you something.
Why me shouldn't say nothing against it? Why me shouldn't say nothing about what he said?
Well, I'm going to answer. You see the man with them finding at the barrel of Conrad Lane?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I know him from James Street. I grew up with him.
Yeah.
You know, see a man on runway from West Kingston, come at James Street, them you them give them shelter. Them want take what the man yard from him and adapt him dead for. Shop him to pieces.
So what that have to do with the, me I say? That me answer. Oh,
right.
That answer
no,
me. That not answer
in
me.
In other circumstances, they know. Them, yeah. them chop up the man from yard, you know.
Yeah.
Them run away from freedom community coming up
yeah.
him one.
Yeah.
And chop him up in a for
yeah.
So what the police should have done, you know,
that not have nothing to do with where the me I say.
No, shoot them, yes.
Shoot who? Who they must shoot?
The gunman at that, the mayor.
But all you know says that, no, him said, shoot who? Shoot who?
Shoot the gunman.
No, wait, him say,
man, listen, bag them, we are
killing them. Wait there, listen to me.
Black lives.
Listen to me, I said,
black lives.
Listen to me, I said, man.
Yeah.
Him never say much shoot gunman, you know.
Where are you going to shoot?
Wait there, him said, crime, you remember, where him name there? Where him name? You remember, Shira, they said the same thing. When Shira said shoot, I ask question later.
Yeah, can we have the same problem I face in West Kingston?
Yeah, so where you say now that if you see a youth on the road and him look suspicious, you must shoot him and ask question later.
No, the man never said that. The man not talk about you look suspicious and
where
the man couldn't that it be lunacy. The man had deal with them get up. You
don't a lunatic if you just say that. A lunatic just
no,
say that.
No, I mean, face the reality, no?
Then no face me, I face reality.
I don't every day and say, youth, I listen to and yeah. I teach you things, you know?
All right.
You have some youth right now, you know?
Yeah.
Where them not have no regard to life. Them have a
yeah,
gun in their yeah, hand. Yeah, gun in
all right.
Hand.
So
and
you
when
must
them see you come, beg you something, no?
Yeah.
Beg you something out of your salary, no? If you make up your face and not answer them,
yeah.
Next thing you know, you feel a cold steel in your head back.
So you must shoot the youth them when you see them with a gun and then ask question later. That's
yeah,
what you're saying.
Never say kill them, say shoot them. What you do with that? Him never say kill them, him say shoot them. What you do with
so
that?
How much time you see policeman now shoot youth with gun and him live?
How much time you see? Well, maybe not very often.
Yeah, so you say no. From a youth, have a gun. You must kill him and then ask question later.
All right. Why him have the gun?
So why them have quotas?
The man never say him. The man
why
never say kill
quotas?
Him. Say shoot. There is a difference.
No. Between shooting and killing.
Yes. So you can shoot now and we have the gun.
I can't say you go to the same school where me go, man.
No, me, my sister, Juliet.
Hear what I'm saying. Him say. Yeah. We cannot have these killings continue to happen in our parish. So I am suggesting to the police to shoot first and then ask question later. Hear what I'm saying? You cannot have these killings in the parish.
True.
Yeah, all right. So you can't have killings in the parish. So anybody where you see, especially a man with a gun, shoot him. I ask question later.
Yeah, when you shoot him, you ask him, where you get the gun? Why you shoot the man?
Or you go ask him again and you don't kill him. You don't kill him, you know?
The man, yes, still, I do the same thing. You go Kingston technically, you know?
Yeah.
It's a very I institution of learning. The man says, shoot them first and then ask the question after he never says, kill
them. Mama, may I ask you a question now? You think that is a just argument to say? That you think
very
that,
just.
You're supposed to say that.
You're
supposed to say it.
Of course.
Okay.
Come on, we yeah. You them now come to you and say, criminal,
all right, suppose you go a party uptown and you see a youth, a brown skinned youth with a gun. Police just come in there and shoot him and ask question later. Suppose you go uptown in a party where me already go and me see them. You tell me now, say, if you see a brown skinned youth in the party, with a gun. And the police come in there. I'm supposed to shoot him and ask question later.
Yes, shoot him too.
I'm supposed to shoot him too.
Yes. Him have a gun him, which him do have no authority for having.
Oh, you know him have no authority for having.
What give him the authority for having?
Oh, you know. Me ask, you, oh, you know. Him no can have a license feed. Him no can have a license feed.
Eh?
At 20 year old, you can have a license for your gun.
Yes, him can have a license.
Then, you know him to have a license for the gun.
Oh, all right. If him have a license for the gun, he wouldn't have to display the gun in that.
No, we don't talk about no display. No, Bridget, Mama, you're not talking about no display. Me say.
But in a party, where am I doing the gun in the party?
Oh, you mean, then,
party
then trap him and travel. Then not trap him and travel with him gun. Him and travel with him gun.
Yeah.
Yeah, then if him and travel with him gun.
You are look panic from the way, you know.
No, which way?
Leave the gunman alone.
No.
Let him wreak havoc and then you come back on and say.
No, but that's the way you are
saying. No, 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 the police, no, no, no.
That's the way you are saying. You are saying that.
Nah,
man, that's what you are saying.
Uno, I promote. Uno pretends on the
night. Uno, who's Uno? Who's Uno? Who's Uno? Who's Uno? Who's Uno? Who is Uno?
Who is Uno? When he was 14, come from my same Central Kingston.
Yeah.
Him kill Damian. Him kill 14. Him come and text me in the day, come look for.
Police ever kill anybody with not yet?
Yes, police do that.
Yeah, police. That you know, you have any police will push gun find you and kill them?
Yes, yeah, police will do that.
Yeah, so let me ask you a question now. This mayor is unjust when him say. Which you are use some semantics, don't I say? Him not really mean killing. Him mean just shoot them.
Yes. All right. Never say kill them.
Shoot them in them finger. Shoot out the gun out of them hand.
Yes.
You know police are shoot out gun out of people hand.
Yeah, man. Yeah, police will do it. Up to recently, police will three of them with gun in a.
So that the mayor said. So that the mayor mean the man.
That is exactly what the man said. Call them creep.
Shoot the gun out of the man hand and shoot him in them foot. You hear him say that? Not the reasoning.
That is exactly what the man means.
No, he may ask you if him did say it.
He may ask you if him did say it. No, he never said shoot out the gun.
He said shoot him in the foot. He said shoot him in the foot.
First, you say I ask question.
Yeah,
answer.
So
based on... Whoever asks the question if you shoot, if you kill.
Given our culture in Jamaica.
What is our culture?
Our culture in Jamaica with police. Police take gun and give on youth and then shoot them.
And police
we have not. I never said all police do it.
It's police. Vietnam, policeman.
Police.
Like a man have put a gun on him. That gunman that used to work for the police, you know.
Which gunman?
Anytime you see them put a gun on him.
Vietnam, police secure. Police secure. Youth come from party with in a car. And then fire the shot at the car and kill the little girl and nothing. Yeah, I said the girl is involved in some criminality, right? That's the way I said. That's
which
why.
One?
You remember the little immaculate girl where the police them shoot up the car and kill her in the car?
Oh, no, I don't know. Well, the police say people over Portmore say the car nobody robbed them.
All right, and the policeman them who shot up the police car, the police them did rob somebody too, don't it?
The police car.
You remember the police
tonight?
Yeah, you remember the police them when they shut up the police car?
Yeah, with
I don't know who did not the car, but some big police in the car. Them police said that do something wrong. Why the police them shut up them car, right?
I don't know, but them shut up them car.
Yeah, all right. So me I said to you now, the police when him
you
say.
You go all over the place. You go all over the place.
Me not go over the place. Me I try to show what the me I say. And the me I talk about. Yeah, the me I say.
In respect to Lilam, is Mayor of Savalana, which is in the parish of West Malak.
Yeah.
In facing the parish, the parish have one party rule. So the parish now say, why people, business community, school, picnic, elder.
Yeah, all of them are getting shot.
Don't talk to you, player, Taurus Riley. Them shooting,
I
book my book and
I kill them. Shoot all the willies. Yeah, you can't tell me about how shooting.
The man addressing him parish and the people in him parish.
Yeah.
Said to the officers in him parish.
Yeah.
You hear me? Them have them gun. Yeah. Them come out West Malan with doing you for this culture.
That is what I'm saying in the statement.
No, but him attack to West Malan. He never talk about where you're going about Beverly's and see Brown. You can't. Him said to West Malan, the police in West Malan, hear me? Shoot them. And when you shoot them, by shooting them, you're disarming them. Find out, because in don't think some of them come from West Malan neither. So I know where them people come from and create this murder in West Malan.
They were not Jamaican, man. I know Jamaican, them. And some savage, them will come from somewhere else.
You know, say Asian, they come here for fight.
No, me, I say, as some savage, them.
You know, the man, them Asians was important and is fighting. No, Jamaican people are talking
to them. So the man, them woman attack Asian, but not Jamaican.
The man don't know how to kill him, never used to see it. in a yeah. parish when born and grow.
But a whole heap of things we never used to say in, a, in
right.
our parish, yeah.
Come on, we'll find out who them is.
By shooting them first.
Shoot them and then question them and shoot them really is where they come from. And that the man I deal with can have to take in parish.
Remember, when you have to pay, Multilink all the way. Multilink, rule with control. Conditions apply. See the price for details.
A bakery has vacancies for a baker, pastry chef, trainee baker, bakery supervisor, cashiers with CXC qualifications, driver salesman, mature persons only. Call 939-2799. That's 939-2799.
Ladies, this Thursday at the famous nightclub in Portmore, it's all about Magnum Divas Night Out, featuring Conscience Live. Ladies free all night, must be 18 years and older. Drink responsibly. Magnum Divas Night Out, Conscience Live, this Thursday.
The CB Pan Chicken Championships rolls into the Sunshine City of Port Moore with the Eastern Regional Eliminations. Saturday, September 28th from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. at the UDC Car Park, smack in the middle of...
Yeah, Pepsi, live for now.
30% off. Just today, starting at 6 p.m., get 30% off the entire store at Payless Shoes. That's right, starting at 6 p.m. today, you get 30% off on the latest styles for you and your family. Remember, promotion starts at 6 p.m. today at Payless Shoes. Offer expires September 19, 2013.
Remember to keep your Super Lotto tickets safe and always check the press for results or any Supreme Ventures outlets after each draw. The time by Super Lotto is...
Yeah, the time is 7 minutes past the hour of 4 o'clock. Bustamante got on a man to be here. The same statement there was made against the Rasta them in a 1963. Shoot them and ask question later. It's weird. We're in a serious position. Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Muta?
Yes, sir.
How you doing, sir?
Blessed man.
Muta, you see, with my mayor here in South?
Yes.
I think the mayor really don't mean like that, you know, Muta, because sometimes they write up that are in the Gleaner paper. And they blow it out of proportion.
It's not a wrong write-up because they quote him. It's not somebody has said him said it. Quote him.
Yeah, but Muta, but sometimes, you know, they rewrite up and say this Muta about the mayor. Because I know that mayor very well. He's a very nice and professional man.
Yeah, but when I say, Bridget, this quote, them quote him. And the lady there is defending the court. She now say, yeah. It's quote, them quote him wrong, you know. They must defend the court. So, it's quote, them quote him.
Because I know that mayor very well. He's a very nice and professional man.
Yeah, but when I say, Bridget, well. This quote, them quote him. And the lady there is defending the court. She now say, yeah. It's quote, them quote him wrong, you know. They must defend the court. So, it's quote, them quote him. Nobody come out and say, him never say so. And now this lady come and I defend the court. Say, this is, she put a thing to it, say, this is what I mean. So she not denying same say so. She has said, this is we now I break it out of context. That is what she has said.
But what I'm saying in the motor, yeah. You see, this mayor in South, he's a very nice gentleman. Can I tell you, Muta? Yeah. Let me tell you this, you know.
Yeah, but
you
see, everybody nice in Jamaica, pressure reach everybody. Everybody start not stop nice.
Yes, but Jamaica, I don't believe he kind of means
Jamaica,
that, you know,
Muta.
Not taking a call for my mayor.
Yeah, Jamaica, have a way for me, Christian Costo. Yeah, Jamaica, have a way for me, Christian Costo. You know, them way there, him could have nice little more. Me I go half away, it said, and because the reason why I'm upset about it is because some other people in our history, they said the same thing about Jamaican people. Some other people, they said the same thing. As a matter of fact, one man come and say it against a specific set of people, which is Rasta, them say it against. You know, see, and we see where that lead to.
I think I know they're listening inside your office and all these things. Because
them used to pay. Them
and,
used
know,
to pay people £1, one shilling for shot Rasta.
Yes.
You think I joke me? Me I tell you that. Say there is in 1963, they was given £1, one shilling for shot Rasta, and police used to use Rasta image for train alpha in a them firing range. Shoot first and ask questions. nobody not nana ya jump on the mayor when the head of the police force in Jamaica.
Yes.
Say that statement should not be made. The head of the police. So I don't know if the head of the police are idiot like me. Yeah, the head of the police must be idiot like me because me and the head of the police are the same thing. What kind of statement that?
Oh my God! Well, I don't think he kind of mean like that, you know, because I know him personally. We are
well,
and this mayor in South, I can tell you, he's so outstanding. Can I tell him, Muta?
No, I don't. Nice watch out! I know, have nothing against the mayor, Bridget.
I know.
I just have said the statement where the mayor made.
With them writing the paper.
It's same way like, no, I know with them writing the paper. It's same way like, oh, I wanted to come out and make some statement and then them jump on you. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Artists come out and make certain statement and the whole people them, the whole people them jump on the artists and make the artists can't do what they're supposed to do. So me, I say to you now that if we look on this thing here, the statement, and the police come on and say,
Oh boy. I think he's an awesome person.
Yes.
Yeah, man. A good man in a motor, trust me. But as I say, they write it in the green because I see it and I hear Ron with it and I hear you with it and I hear Elise and majority.
Yeah. And I hear the police, head of the police with it.
Yes.
I hear the head of the police force with it. And I say, wow. A period that about the place you are misinterpreting me, I saw.
Yeah, but our mayor, Muta, me tell you, the first mayor, he's for the people, you know.
Anyway, you hold on, because Zofa signal me if you take some out. Hold on.
No problem.
Mother's Bakery.
This is the Stepping Razor. My producer, assistant producer, just give me a thing here where the police, the assistant commissioner of police, Warren Clark, the commanding officer for Area 1, Westmoreland, Hanover, St. James, and Trelawney, was dismissive of Moore's suggestion. This is the mayor I'm at dismiss. And in quote, the advice runs counter to our rules of engagement. We are duty bound to fire only when our lives or somebody else's life is threatened. This is what Police Assistant Commissioner of Police Warren Clark say, the commanding officer for Area 1, Westmoreland. Him say, that statement runs counter to our rules of engagement. We are duty bound to fire only when our lives or somebody else's life is threatened, Clark added. This is the Warren Clark. So apparently, this policeman is taking the thing out of context. Why should I really feel any way about what I said? I mean, I feel aware. This man feel aware. It's not something where the police give credence to. If the police had the pen pan to stop the war, the police have said, no, you can't go shoot a man just because you see him with a gun. I mean, and then go ask him questions. No, it's not at all. When your life is threatened. So, if you feel say the man threatening your life because he have a gun in his hand, just shot everybody. You understand? I just saw it go. Just take it to the extreme. And shoot. Where were they now? Oh, the bridge is gone. All right. Okay. I want to play this thing here. Believe you me. Don't call me yet. I want people to just listen to this thing here. It's really a funny little anecdote, really. Believe you me. It's funny. You have to listen to the whole light. Keenly. Okay. Listen keenly to where I go on here, so now.
Hey, you're about to listen to the Bolt Buster exclusively on KTU.com. Don't forget, listen for the new Bolt Busters weekdays at 6:05, 7:05, and 8:05 with Baltazar and Goomba Johnny on KTU.
Hello?
Good afternoon. I'd like to speak to Mrs. Francis. Is that she's in, please?
This is she.
Mrs. Is this a cell phone?
Yes, it is. I'm in my car. What can I do for you?
Well, this is Phil McCracken calling from the by school district.
Okay. What is this in reference to?
Your son William attends the school.
Okay, yes he does. Is he all right?
Everything's fine.
You're trying to cut me off. I'm sorry. What can I do for you, sir?
Are you driving right now? Why don't you pull over to the side of the road?
All right. Yes, I'm here. Go ahead.
William is fine.
What? Okay, so what the damn drop. God damn it. I can't stand these goddamn cars. Yeah, okay, I'm sorry. Go ahead. What happened? All right, go ahead. Go ahead. I'm over. I'm parked now. Go ahead.
Mrs. His teacher has been noticing some strange behavior lately.
Oh, really?
Well, this is very awkward for me. We have our suspicions that your son William is heterosexual.
Well, he's heterosexual. Well, what in the world did how'd you find out about this?
William told us himself.
Oh my God! Oh Lord Jesus! Oh my God! My husband is going to have a heart attack. He's going to flip his wig when he hears this one. How am I going to tell my husband my son is heterosexual? He's just going to have a fit. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Why don't you start by telling him that you love your son? You never suspected that your son would be this?
Hell no! Mm-mm. Ain't nobody in our family like that. I ain't never heard. No! Jesus! Oh, Lord, my husband's going to lose his mind. It's all over now. It's all over. And you know the school just called me up?
What?
And told me that William is heterosexual. What? Lord, I'm going to stop praying because I can't believe this is happening to me. Jesus! My son is heterosexual. Can you believe that?
Oh, well,
heterosexual. What is your name?
Phil McCracken.
Mr. McCracken. It's that MTV. It's that MTV. I know that's what it is. Have you seen that MTV? Have you seen them boys from NSYNC? That group there, NSYNC? They're heterosexual, too. Mm-hmm. Heterosexual. I can't believe this. Oh, Lord.
Hello?
Yes, I'm here. I'm going to have to go, sir. I got to call my husband.
Who is Dorothy?
Excuse me?
Dorothy called us up at the radio station. This is KTU, and she told me to get you on a Bolt Buster. You're on a prank phone call.
What do you mean this on the radio? Is this WBLS?
No, it's not WBLS. It's KTU.
You know, my sister is a crazy bitch.
You are so funny. Do you know what heterosexual means?
What it means?
That means he likes girls.
Oh. You know, I'm going to beat her.
Fiery opinion. Thought provoking. Always smoking. Lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Mutabaruka.
It's really amazing picture. Where is it that somebody cut some buckle, some plastic buckle, long way. Them cut it long way so that you still have the buckle mouth intact. But them cut it like them gonna seal it, like it's a boat. Cut out the top of it and left a bottom of it, and them full it of dirt and plant in it. And me I tell you, me see some scallion and some lettuce in the buckle them, man. It's unbelievable. Yeah, man, at a lady, you know, from Mullines Road, where Carly has an ouch. And that you should have do. Go get some buckle, some gallon buckle, and cut the top of it, and full it of dirt, and put some seed in it. And me, I tell you, it's like the person who do it have a string of buckle line off, you know, and scallion, lettuce, the amount of lettuce and scallion when we see in the picture, man. It's amazing, man. So we are say that even if you live in a New Kingston, Pantapa, the highest building in a New Kingston, you can have a nice little garden with certain little food and thing in there. Yeah, man, it's sweet. Remember the bridge in the car from over Portmore until we say the man have one of them water tank when cut the tank in half and him have banana growing up. When you look on the banana them, man, the bunch them gone clear. Yes. Self-reliance is the only science. And that we are working with. This is the stepping razor. The art of war.
Bright lights, neon signs, billboards everywhere.
So with the dopey them don't St. Thomas Technical School there. I really want to find out where I go on because it's really a big commotion.
I don't know about anybody else, but I learn a lot from you on your program.
Well,
cutting edge.
You want me to get the lady?
Stepping razor.
You should have find the lady number and make you call her.
I learn a lot.
Yeah.
And you and running Africa.
Well, I was told that that lady called her at the radio station program them.
Me no know about I alone me listen, so me no know which radio station they
call. No, me just said somebody called me and told me that that lady called all of the radio talk show them. So she's a PNP lady. She expresses her PNP thing.
Oh.
She don't like you talk anything against any PNP people. That's what somebody tell me.
Look here.
Yeah.
If a PNP or a GLP from around.
Yeah, but we not take no side.
Alright.
Yeah, forward we are going. We don't have no side move.
A Jones told me born and grown now.
You see, they know a Jones told me.
I know, sir. PNP wrong. And if labor right wrong, labor right wrong.
Yeah.
Use right and beat wrong.
Yeah, man, that's how we see. That's how we see. But nice to hear you, though.
Yeah?
Nice to hear you. All the children, them?
Them good, man. Yeah, I don't talk to you, no. I'm going to give them dinner. I'm a grandkids, them, you know.
I'm not here.
All right.
And give thanks, yeah?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Heal up Zoff for me.
Yeah, Zoff, they are feeding face.
Tell, I love little Zoff on Friday night, going to Saturday morning.
Zoff are feeding face, yeah, right now.
All right, cool.
With food, a mouthful of food. Yes, the lady said, heal yourself. Yes, she say she love listening to you from Friday. But, hey, that woman didn't know everything we're going for Irie the Rasta. Believe you me, she can repeat back everything when she hear for Irie FM. Yes, she need a medal. Really, she need a medal. Okay. So, with the other part, we play this tune, you know. I really know me hungry. And you know, say me hungry. So when this program is done, believe you me hungry, we dead.
Greetings, Jamuta.
Blessed man.
Enough respect to the eye, man. How are you, man?
Me there, man. Me there, I got you, man.
And how the family?
Every family is going on quite okay.
There, I give thanks and praise, my brother.
Yeah.
But I'm going to call you when the daughter called the eye and I come on, going like she want to play down. The I program, which I know is a university, as a student from your start.
Yeah.
The problem with that lady.
She
called Jerry all the while, you know.
Oh, yeah?
You pick me up? No, you know Jerry.
What do you mean if me know Jerry?
Jerry and the I upon the same page.
Oh, so she's a caller.
You see me?
Yeah.
And the thing is that now, because you know, see certain progress I make.
Yeah.
And we talk of it now.
Yeah.
Them don't like it because what they do is just defend.
Yeah.
Because look at this now. The man make a statement as a general statement he make, you know.
Mm.
Right?
Mm.
And me and you know, say, by law, a man is innocent until proven guilty.
Yeah, well, she has a friend, you have a gun, you forget shot, and you forget shot. And
but nothing can go so. Because look at it now. Minister of Security say, you must forget a divine intervention. You remember?
Yeah.
And this man come now, and because the crime raised up in a fit,
yeah.
Which part in there now?
Yeah.
He must say, watch out now. Shoot first and ask.
That's for sure, the people them who is in power is confused.
That is not the same thing.
One man said them need divine intervention, and the other man said, shoot them.
You see me?
I ask them question later. So, them don't have a clue what's supposed
them
to do.
Them don't have an answer to what is really taking place, my brother.
Yeah,
because they are not for the people.
From one extreme to the next, brethren. From yeah, one extreme motor. To the next. One
and then they want to come blame Rasta now. You pick me up?
Oh, shall I blame Rasta?
Then the woman I trying to do.
Oh, she said Rasta was, I know, like first time Rasta.
Yeah, pick up.
Oh, yeah, she did that to you. See, like me,
and the thing is that it's my brethren, because we are so in tuned to the truth.
yeah.
and the reality of life. Them don't see it our way.
Yeah.
Because the way how them see it
yeah.
is some have and some not have.
Politics.
And we have said, no, what the thing? Mm-hmm. Make, when a man put out, make him can't get.
Yeah.
Because we're not the handout business. Mm-hmm. I don't know what we are now.
Mm-hmm.
We're not sitting down and written about if we can handout anything to us.
Mm-hmm.
We have said, no, we are work. We want plant. We want the self-reliance, etc., etc.
Yeah.
Because we are responsible for our health.
Health, yes.
Our health is our wealth. Not true?
Yeah, yeah, of course.
So it's because
course.
We have that independency, but we know
self-reliance and the greatest science.
You see what I talk about?
Yes. Yeah.
So because we know now support where they must support.
Yeah.
They must say right now we are fight.
Yeah, we're not fighting our help, we're trying to help the situation.
But if we are fighting, we are fighting for our right.
Yeah, but our help, we're help still. We're not our help, we're help.
They're not true, my brother. No,
we're
born
down
and
below. We are born
down and below. But what now? They're so one-sided. They cannot see what we are seeing, my brother.
Yeah, yeah, man.
I'm glad all the I defend it.
Yeah.
I know why you defend it. Abaka are the truth that I deal with.
Yeah, man. Give thanks, brethren.
Give thanks, my brother.
Yeah, yes. Oh, so the lady there is a well-known the lady there is a well-known car. I know the first man called me. I tell me about her. I think the first good girl I call is. Oh, such a jump and cut stepping razor. Yeah, so no. Wow. Wow. I never know, say. Okay, I swear to God, PNP and GLP a fight on radio now again. Can I remember them did have talk show in a Monty Perkins, PNP and GLP every day, the same call of them call every day. It's either them I defend PNP or I defend GLP. So I see where I go on here, so now them I try to turn the program them in a either PNP or GLP. Watch out. None apologetically. We not defend neither PNP nor GLP. At that, me I say non apologetically. Me no one come brand me. When them hear me a lick out against certain things, them a feel say because the man they are PNP, I threw my PNP right lick out against him. Because when I take us, when I walk sideways, a forward we go, we have two side and one forward. And at that we are work with, and I work with a two side business. Are one-sided because we don't want to lean. So if a guy or a girl here we talk on the radio, nobody come go on like say because them here we are leak out against all the crime rate are going on, and the one Mr. Bunting are going like say he might make progress and we are leak that them feel say boy right now we are take off for GLP because then now we are going to look on all GLP and say what them did that do when them did that there and them are run up them mouth. We don't take the side, we are talking the thing as how it go. You know, see it? A vice, we are getting to the viceless. And hope for the hopeless. That's why the youth them listen to the program. The most people who listen to this program and the program than that. That's why youth are listening. Are very conscious of that. So, we don't really want to come and turn the program like say they want to come. Because them hear your lick out against a specific thing. If that man never saw him, I say, wouldn't even know him. We don't even know the me of them. A one man in Jamaica me know, you know, by name. And a Angela Brown. Me don't know no other me. Believe you me. If a man tell me what the next me, me don't know no other me. A one man name me know, Angela Brown. And the reason why me know for her name is because before she and me, she did involved with certain vibes and this and this and this and that. That's the only me I know but can call her name. And me know say she a PNP. I mean I defend Angela Brown PNP status. Me know say Angela Brown is Angela Brown. So if this man never say where I say, I would never know the mayor. If a guy did give me a competition, I say, who is the mayor of Savannah Lamar? I would lose. But when the man push up himself that way, I have to say, no, that can't work, Mr. Mayor. Can't work. You understand? Just like how we are say, Mr. Minister of Agriculture. I would have people who did the reason why they might fight against the Minister of Agriculture when they might dance. I because I'm not dance walls. But I bet you say, if him did a dance walls, you don't hear nobody say nothing. We don't fight, we just say that. So it's not like we are defend PNP because we say Roger Clark, a dance, the Jamaican way, and people say, oh, disgusting. We don't see it as disgusting. We see it as a Jamaican, a dance like a Jamaican. So we see it. You don't see that, so it go. Me no PNP because me say that. You understand? So, we don't want people come bring the PNP and GLP conversation, come and tell me, like, say, yeah, so you defend PNP because you lick out against me. No, we are lick out against madness. And that we are lick out against madness. Anyway, the madness come push up its head. And that we are lick out against. Yes. So, we are waiting for the cash part thing. The cash part thing is a problem in Jamaica, you know, because you know. Believe you me. You know how you would come to me and show me last night. He said, Muta, you ever notice, say, first time when you dream something, you could have got to a whole person and him interpret the dream for you. Nowadays, people are dreaming, you know. And the first thing going up to their mind, you know, is cash part. What you dream about? Drunk, okay. A number this, that, or what you dream about? Who are? Yeah, yeah, no, that. You say, rotted. So there's no esoteric or there's no sweetness about dreams more than you have to link it with the cash part. Again, for some man, I say, well, you know, when you dream about debt, it means this and that and this and that. And you sit down and you get a nice reasoning about this and that. Nowadays, as a man dreams something, you ask me dreams, something, a woman left me, you know, oh, a number 166, that. Okay, all right, go buy that. Move. Dream don't make no sense again. I like dream becomes a non-entity now. It's like pick a pow. Remember that thing? China man pick a pow. Yes. Everybody have a little paper and a man and a mark, this and a mark, that and a mark. That dream. Dream become numbers now. And numbers mean that you can win money and you beat up half your whole life after this idea that your future rests in a number, and you will be liberated when that number comes up. What a life we're living in now. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, we must shoot and ask question later. I wonder what number that is. What number that is, if we start doing that. Meanwhile, the government set up a organization for looking to corruption. And when the organization come and give them the outcome of this idea of corruption, them still refuse to accept it. So why did they set up the commission in the first place? Why did they set up the commission in the first place? That is really the problem. Step in.
No matter how me cooking sweet, the taste not complete without the Grace tomato ketchup. Grace, bringing good taste to life. The time by Grace tomato ketchup is...
Tinya, for ring up the people them. Wanna get ready for getting a life better. Making a life be more meaningful. Get ready at 5 o'clock. This is the time when Jamaican people secure them situation and them position into a meaningful existence in numbers. Ready? Ready. We are ready to have fun. Yeah, it's off. Okay. So, are they so rich now? Are you so rich? Skygrass. Kabaka. Pyramid. As we are saying, next week we'll be here again. But you know, say for those of us who are, if those of you who are say, with the, you know, say we should probably clang out there on Sunday down our street there. Yes, so we are going down there again. Forever young. Can we feel that forever young levels and vibes? You understand? So yeah, we are going down there, spilling the good music, vintage style. We want you know, the man called Babandi, you know. Yeah, we want you look know, Babandi. Believe you me. Yeah, bridging for life, man. Trust me. Yes. We want also you look know, the ones them in France. Paris, to be exact. Some sisters were up there. Believe you me. We don't know how they manage it, boy. Me, I tell you. Because right now, it's like them used to listen to Cutting Edge. And now, we know so it's a different timing because when Cutting Edge are going, I really some serious hours over there, some man. But now, Cutting Edge are going like 2 o'clock here, so now, 2 to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's almost like 8 hours in front of this time here. So at night, they might listen. But the night there is more acceptable. Stepping rays are more acceptable than the night in Europe there than Cutting Edge, where come on, like, early morning, but guess what? The sister them stay up and listen to it. So we want to heal up all them sisters there in France, in Paris to be specific, where tell me, Mutabaruka, yes, your program. Okay, so you already know. We are go from that to this. A big tune. Big, big, big tune we are playing now. Yeah, hear it? A big tune. From 2 o'clock, come right here, so. And we just have a couple minutes left, and we're going to fill it up with music to your ears. Yes. So, here and now, we all left you with this rhythm, I know. Yes. Start out with Bongo Herman. Bongo Herman. Gone, we're gone. We'll go with this song, yeah.